Our processional song is number 777. Here I am, Lord, number 777.
Please rise.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night,
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, we gather together for this liturgy as we pray for that the repose of the soul, Dan, may be welcome into his heavenly kingdom. And as we come together, we pray also for all those who mourn, that the strength and consolation of the love of Jesus Christ may give us hope in this difficult moment. And so, my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Dan, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts, without men ever discovering from beginning to end the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to be glad and do well during life, for every man, moreover, to eat and drink and enjoy the fruit of all his labor is a gift from God. The word of the Lord.
To be sacrificed. The time is here for me to leave this life. I have done my best in the race. I have run the full distance. I have kept the faith. Now the prize of victory is waiting for me, the crown of righteousness, which is the Lord. The righteous judge will give me on that day, and not only to me, but to all those who wait with love for him to appear. The Lord stayed with me and gave me strength, and the Lord will rescue me from all evil and take me safely into his heavenly kingdom. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you.
On behalf of Deacon Dave and our bereavement team and the entire community here at St. Teresa, to the family, friends of Dan gathered together, please know of our prayers and our sympathies for you. And I hope it's a consolation to know that we've been praying for Dan at our daily masses throughout this past week. The first time that I met Dan, it was rather memorable for two reasons. One, I believe either he introduced himself or somebody very quickly told me that he went by the name Red Dog very often. And the second thing is that he gave me a penny with a cross that was cut out of it. And this was probably about 5 years ago when this first happened. And from that time, I got to know him a little bit and got to see a little bit of his character. He would always sit the 7 a.m. Mass right back in one of the spots between the two final pillars. And he was somebody who genuinely had a great faith and desired to share that faith in small ways, but in very charitable ways. He was a man who, whenever he saw a need, if he felt like he could help, he would be there and he would step up. Very early on, there was a family here at St. Teresa, that one of our school families, that was having some financial difficulties. And word got out, and without hesitation, he stepped up and helped that family. And I know that those sort of stories are not isolated events in Dan's life, but they really came from the depths of who he was as a man, and in particular, a man of faith, a man who knew that Jesus Christ loved him and desired to share that love with others. So fitting then that for the gospel today, we read of the Beatitudes
And in the Beatitudes, there is those lines about what it means to be blessed and who is blessed. But we know that within our faith, it is not only a blessing for us, but it is a blessing that flows from us out into the world. And Dan, in particular, he lived that out, that what he received from our Lord Jesus Christ, he desired to give to others. There's a story not too long ago that I think about often, and it's about the love of Christ in our life. There was this intro to theology class in college, and there was this young lady who was taking this class, and she had a fairly simple question for the professor. She asked, why did Christ come when he did? The professor thought about it and then kind of took a theological approach and talked about how from Adam and Eve, the prophets, and everything had been prepared, and that this was the time that Christ was going to come to redeem the hearts of God's people who had fallen away. And she wasn't exactly satisfied. She understood that theological approach. She wasn't exactly satisfied, and so the professor took a different approach. He said, you know, we can even think about it in a biblical sense, that we can actually look very in depth at the prophets and what they foretold, that they were always talking about turning the hearts of the people of God back, this metanoia, this turning back to the Lord, but they had also foretold a coming Messiah. And that if you look at the prophets and what they preached, everything was pointing for the time that Christ did, that Christ came. She still wasn't completely satisfied, and so the professor again took another tact. And he said, you know, we can think very practically that it was fitting that Christ came when he did, because it was at that moment in history that perhaps for the first time, the message that Christ wanted to spread throughout the world, the message of the gospel, of his love and mercy, could go throughout the known world. That because of the Roman Empire, because of the peace and the road system, that he could send out the disciples and they could carry this message throughout the world. And so it was practical, and it was fitting that Christ came when he did. A college student, she still wasn't completely satisfied, and she continued to think about that question, and she came back after the next class, and she said, I know why Christ came when he did. She said that all those other explanations made sense, but for her, what made the most sense was that Christ came when he did for the good thief, the one who died next to Christ on the cross. And in the biblical narrative, things could have been shifted a lot or a little, and they probably wouldn't have made much of a difference for many people. But for that one soul who needed reconciliation right at the moment of his death, everything had to happen precisely when it did, so that Christ could encounter that and share his love and bring that one soul to heaven. Now, certainly, maybe not theologically, biblically, and certainly not practically, is that the best answer. But what that college student understood is the power of Christ's love. That it's not absurd to think that he would do all that he did when he did it for that one soul, because that is how dear each and every one of our hearts is to our Lord. That he continues to reach out with his love. He wants to fill us with his blessing. And when we receive that blessing, we are called to live in that love and let that love shine throughout our life. That same powerful love that reconciled that one soul who died next to Christ is the same love that Jesus Christ has for Dan and each and every one of us in this church today. And so we come as we remember the life that Dan lived, as we give thanks for the many blessings that he had in his life and the blessings that he shared, and as we commend his soul to our Lord Jesus Christ in this moment, we do so with hope that is founded upon that powerful love, that from his baptism, Dan was promised eternal life, and that our Lord Jesus Christ walked with him throughout his life, in the good times and in the difficult times. The love of Christ remains. So we commend our brother to the Lord in confidence, and we pray that this same love, the love of Jesus Christ, may lift us up in this difficult moment in our lives.
We trust the love and care of our Heavenly Father. We lift up our prayers and needs.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Dan, who went home to be with the Lord, may his homecoming be a tender and joyful celebration, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. With trust, we lift up all those who have gone before us and all of us who are still on our journey. May we one day share in the joy of being together again in the dwelling place that the Lord has prepared for us, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. With concern, we lift up those who are sick or dying or who have lost a loved one. May their pain bring God's comfort, their discouragement bring his strength, and their loneliness bring his friendship, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the safety of our armed forces, wherever they may be serving, and our police and firefighters. Lord, please hold them in your loving hands and protect them. Along with their dedication, we pray that we may have peace in a troubled world. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless the caregivers at Good Sam Hospital and 7 Acres Senior Living for their care and support to Dan, as well as to the family during this difficult time. We pray for the doctors and nurses who care for Dan. Lord, be with them as they continue to care for the sick. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, be with the family as they learn to live with their present sorrow. We offer our prayers with sincere hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, as we silently speak the deepest needs of our hearts. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up to you, Heavenly Father, all families who struggle and live in hardship. Lord, give them faith and courage in the difficulties they may today be called to face, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and strength, you listen in love to those who cry out to you. Hear our prayers that we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Grant them the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now be seated.
Number 680, We Walk by Faith. Number 680.
By faith and not by sight, no gracious words we hear from him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod, but in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and seek where you faith is done in realms of clearer light. We may behold you as you are in full and endless sight.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept us, sir.
we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Anne, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Dennis our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Dan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Receiving today, you may come forward to receive a blessing by crossing your arms, or you may remain in your pews. This time we ask you to please kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. The body of Christ.
Number 930, Taste and See, number 930. Taste and See.
see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Bless the Lord at all times. Praise shall always be on my lips. My soul shall glory in the Lord. For God has been so good to me.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Dan may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite everyone to please be seated at this time. The family would like to offer some words of remembrance.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Sydney, Dan's youngest daughter. On behalf of my sister, Bailey, and our family, I want to express our thanks and gratitude for your presence as we remember our father and celebrate his new eternal life in heaven. Dan was more than just a father to us. He was a beacon of kindness and compassion to everyone he encountered. Whether it was a passing stranger, a neighbor, a friend, or a family member, he had the ability to touch lives with his genuine warmth and generosity. And yes, as stubborn as he could be at times, it was this very quality that defined his unapologetic authenticity. He stayed true to himself, never afraid to voice his opinions and stand for what he believed in. Through his stubbornness, he instilled in us all the importance of staying authentic to our own selves and principles. To strangers, he was the person who would brighten their day with a simple hello, showing them that kindness could be found in the smallest gestures. As a neighbor, Dan embodied the spirit of community. He didn't just live on a street. He cultivated relationships, mowing lawns, delivering flowers, and always ready to strike up a conversation that went beyond mere pleasantries. Dan's friendships were built on a foundation of care and concern. He didn't just ask how you were, he truly listened, offering support, advice, and wisdom without hesitation. As a brother, Dan was a pillar of strength and a model of loyalty to his siblings. His love for them knew no bounds, and he was always there, whether in person or from a distance, ready to lend a hand or provide comfort. He cherished his bonds with them and loved them dearly. Lastly, as a father, he loved my sister and I unconditionally with his whole heart. He supported us through every stage of life and was never too judgmental of our decisions. He was a strong body to lean on and a shoulder to cry on. He infused our days with laughter and created memories that will forever hold dear. To share a few of those memories, he invented the infamous ice cream dance for our nightly ice cream treats. He was a strong advocate for game nights or even game mornings. He came to every sports game to support us, even when we didn't get to play. He would sing the same Rodney Atkins songs with me on our way to my soccer games. He put a trampoline in his backyard for us and our friends to enjoy every day after school. He wrote separate I love you poems and called us every night to recite them. He brought our pet ferrets to school for an impromptu show and tell. He eagerly and patiently taught me how to drive in his truck. He spent many weekends helping my sister with strenuous yard work. And he never missed an opportunity to tell us how proud he was of us or how much he loved us. Losing our father will be one of the most difficult losses in our lifetime. This has made us realize how truly blessed and lucky we were to have a father like Dan. Without his example, encouragement, advice, and most importantly, his love, we wouldn't be the women we are today. We are eternally grateful for his presence in our lives and will honor his memory with kindness, compassion, selflessness, humor, and perseverance. As we bid farewell to Dan, we'd like to offer you all something today. Our father used to carry around cross pennies to share with those who touched his life. These pennies were not just a symbol of his faith, but a reflection of his love for others. Today, we have brought these pennies to share with all of you who knew and loved him. Please take one as you leave today and keep it close, on a keychain, bracelet, in your car, or on your nightstand. Let it serve as a reminder to hold your loved ones dear and to live a life filled with the same love and generosity that defined Dan. Thank you for everything, Dad. We love you always and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Number 519, Sing to the Mountains. Number 519.